Welcome back. Let's talk about designing trading strategies based on the failure of UIP. Uncovered interest rate parity says that the dollar return to a dollar deposit is the same with the dollar return to a deposit in Europe. This is the approximation form of UIP. We derive this by taking logs and using a log approximation. The version without approximation is very similar, but has this gross rate of return, so 1 plus R instead of just R. So the top one is the one we usually use, and it's a slight approximation, and the bottom one is the precise one we derived from this exercise of no arbitrage in currency markets. So the idea is the following. If UIP does not hold, either because the left-hand side is greater or the right-hand side is greater, we should be able to take a loan in the country with the low return and make a deposit in the country with a high return, and in 1 year's time pocket the difference. So let's look at one example of that. Let's say that the return is greater in Europe. So if the dollar return is greater in Europe than in the US, then there should be a way for us to pocket the interest rate difference, the return differential, through a sequence of trades. So let's design that next. So interest rates are low in the US and the relevant return is high in Europe. So we will be taking a loan in the US and then buying euros with that loan and depositing that amount in Europe. And then in 1 year's time, we're going to bring it back by buying dollars. So the steps will be the following. First, we will take a loan in the US. So we take a $1 loan in the US. The size of the loan will not matter because you should be able to scale this up or down. As long as prices don't change, you should be able to make, in some sense, you should be able to arbitrage this interest rate differential. So we will start with a $1 loan in the US. So we take a $1 loan in the US and we promise to pay 1 plus R dollar in 1 year's time. So that's going to be at the end of this process, we're going to pay back this loan in 1 year's time. Next, we will use our $1 we borrowed and we're going to buy euros. And now the question is, how many euros can we buy with $1? So E is the number of dollars it takes to buy 1 euro. So if we have $1, this will be 1 over E dollar over euro. This is how many euros we will have. That's how many euros we can buy with our $1 we borrowed. Next, we will deposit these many euros in an European bank account. This should be a term account. It should be a 1 year deposit. So something like a certificate of deposit or some other instrument that has a fixed term of 1 year. And when we do that, what happens in 1 year? In 1 year, we will have how many euros? Well, the bank will give us an interest rate, R euro, on our deposit. And we deposited these many euros. So in 1 year, the balance of our European bank account will read this. And this again, it's a euros quantity. So we started with $1 today. We immediately turned that into euros, deposited that in a 1 year term bank account in Europe. And then in 1 year, we have this many euros in the European bank. Next, we will exchange these euros into dollars, so we can bring back this return. In 1 year's time, the exchange rate will be different from what it was today. The exchange rate today is just E dollars per euro. So this is the current exchange rate, the one that prevails in the spot market today. There is uncertainty about the level of the exchange rate in 1 year's time. So when we think about this arbitrage strategy, we're going to think about our beliefs or our expectations about future exchange rates. So this E, superscript E, is our expectations about the nominal exchange rate in 1 year's time. So when I want to evaluate whether this strategy will allow me to break even or to make money or lose money, I need to think about what are my expectations today about the exchange rate in 1 year. So the point of that remark is that I will evaluate this future euro quantity based on my beliefs today. So I have euros, and the question is, how many dollars can I buy with these euros? Right, so this is a euro quantity I will have to multiply by the expected exchange rate so I can get rid of the euro and be left with dollars. So in the fifth step of this strategy, I will buy dollars in 1 year. So after I withdraw my term deposit and I get this many euros, I buy dollars with that. So when I buy dollars with that, this is how many euros I had, and now I'm going to multiply by my belief about what the exchange rate will be in 1 year's time. So this is now a dollars amount. It's an amount of dollars. So this is what I expect today to get in 1 year by pursuing this strategy. Of course, now I got my dollars back from engaging in this European adventure. I need to pay back the initial loan I took. So I'm going to take this dollar amount, and subtract what I owe to the US bank. This is the loan I took in step one. I went to a US bank and I said, give me $1 and I'll pay you one plus R dollar in 1 year's time. And the bank said, fine. So this is what I got from my European trades. And now I pay back the loan with interest. And because we assume that the interest rate, the dollar return in the US is lower than the dollar return in Europe. This is exactly the right hand side of that, and this is the left hand side, so this is positive. So what this means is that after paying back my initial loan, I get to pocket the difference. So this is the idea of the arbitrage. You look at the rate of return across the two destinations, you express them in the same currency, so we have dollar returns to a US deposit and dollar returns to a euro deposit. So we look at rates of return expressed in the same currency, and whenever they are not equal, there is a strategy like this which allows you to make money by borrowing where the rate of return is low and depositing where the rate of return is high. So we broke this down into several discrete steps. So I do expect you to be able to derive such a strategy, to design such a strategy with this type of step-by-step reasoning. In particular, you should be able to tell me the steps you need to take if the inequality would be reversed. So the interest rate is higher in the US, the dollar return would be higher in the US than in Europe. Then you would proceed in the opposite manner. You would take a loan in Europe and you would deposit in the US, and eventually you would have to buy euros to pay back your euro loan in Europe. So that's going to be something important for you to practice.